Hi guys, welcome back to another video and welcome to my channel if you are new. Hi, I'm Femke and in today's video I wanted to share with you this beautiful pink and purple super floral holographic glitter design that I did on my own natural nails. Unfortunately, after wearing this design for like 2 to 3 weeks, I broke a couple of nails. There were some tears in there and I had to shorten them quite a bit. That is why I have like super short nails at the moment, but it's a perfect opportunity to use some poly gels, try that out for a change, and just grow them out back healthy and long again. But if you want to know how I made this, please keep on watching. And of course, if you are new to my channel and you haven't subscribed yet, I would really highly appreciate it if you would do so. Hit that gray notification bell to be notified every time I upload a new video. But to start off this manicure, I still had that little bit of silver gel polish on my thumb. Like, I just didn't want to grow out, I just couldn't file it down and stuff like that. But yeah, for the pointer finger and the middle finger, I still had a little bit of builder gel on there. I just didn't want to file it all the way down in case of damaging my natural nails. Looking back at it, it would have been such a bad thing because I had to cut them down all anyways. But yeah. The colors that I'm using today are all by Madam Glam. I'm showing you them here right now. I really love that color combination of like the pinky purple tones. And of course, before you go in with your color gels, always make sure to add a base coat first. I'm just going in with the Soak Off base coat by Madam Glam. Once again, I love this brand. It is just fabulous. It has great quality and it's not that hard to remove afterwards either. Just file off the top coat, let it soak with some acetone for like 10 minutes and you can just scrape it off and your natural nail is undamaged and in perfect condition. But yeah, I'm just going to apply that to every single nail, but starting off with the thumb as usual. I feel like personally for me, starting off with the thumb and just doing that, like finishing up that nail first, works really handy. You won't like bunk your nails into anything, make dents in your gel polish that might not be cured yet. So that is why I always go in and do my thumb fully, like finish it off with top coat as well before I continue to the other four nails. But first up, I'm using this beautiful pink shade and I'm going to apply 2 coats of that. Every single gel polish by Madam Glam has to be cured for 30 seconds in LED or a full minute in UV. Personally, I only use LED lights because I feel like those are like better for the skin and stuff like that. Because I do tend to change up my manicure quite a bit, quite often. So yeah, I don't want to damage my skin or anything like that. So that is why I use LED lights only. I do get frequently asked what light I use. I don't have an LED light by Madam Glam, but I do have one by Pink Jellock, which is a really, really nice lamp. I use it all the time. I have the smaller one, but I do have 2 bigger lamps as well, which are also LED. But I think one of them is from Born Pretty Store and another one was sent out to me from Banggood or something like that. Those are really nice, but I don't really use them for my hands because I have quite small, narrow hands and fingers. So yeah, I don't need a huge LED light on my desk all the time. So yeah, what I wanted to do for this design, as I mentioned, 3 gorgeous pinky purple colors. I'm going to do some dry brush technique on here, but with a little bit more polish on the brush than I usually do when I do a dry brush technique design with regular nail polishes. Because these are gels, you don't need much product anyways. They are quite pigmented and just look at this beautiful color. This one is called Popsicle, by the way. And I think I'm also using Angel Wings and Sakura, which are also 2 of my favorite colors. But just look at how fun this color combination is. It is so cute, so girly, really feminine. I just love it. Like, if you have been staying and hanging around here at my YouTube channel for a longer period of time, you know that I love my pink colors. So yeah, this is just a design it kind of was like stuck in my mind for a couple of months to do so, but I didn't want to do a design like this in winter, so I felt like let's just keep it like in the back of my mind until it's spring summertime. And yeah, I just love this little design, but I did want to add a little bit of sparkle, so that's what I'm going to do with this lovely holographic super finely milled glitter by Catrice Cosmetics. It is from a limited edition from like 2, maybe even 3 years ago already, but I really love it, and I'm just taking a fluffy makeup brush that I only use for glitter applications. So I'm just going to like press some glitter into the sticky layer of the cured gel, and there was a little cat hair stuck in there, so I had to remove that first because I didn't want to encapsulate any cat hairs this time. Yeah, I know that a lot of you also have like cats and dogs, and you know what that's like. If you have like animals with fur walking around, even walking through your entire working area, like there's fur everywhere, and sometimes hairs get stuck into your polishes. So yeah, I think it's quite relatable to most people watching. But once you have applied your glitter, of course you can apply way more if you feel like it. I just wanted to dazzle a little bit on there, not too much. I still wanted to have the full effect of the three colors that I used to make those still be very visible, and I just topped it off with a no wipe top coat. But I also wanted to add a cute design, which is a stamped design from this Nicole Diary plate. I think I've used this one the most out of all of my plates because I just love the floral designs that are on here, and it's just gorgeous. I just really love these, especially like the floral sets with the abstract lines and stuff like that, which I'm going to place here on my thumb as well. Ooh, and I'm also going to place this same stamped like design on my ring finger as well. I just really loved it. Of course, it does cover up quite a bit of that lovely color scheme that you just added, but it still peeks through enough to make it quite obvious and visible. It's not like you're covering the entire nail. So if you are going to use a different stamped image or something else from an image plate, keep it in mind that you don't want to add too much of like white, if you know what I mean. But yeah, I'm just going to continue to do the same effect to every single nail. Starting off with the three different colors as a base first. So for the first nail, for the thumb, I actually used, I think it was angel wings, if I remember correctly. And for the pointer finger, I'm starting off with popsicle and just switching it up between the three colors and just using the other two colors to make the dry brush effect. So yeah, I'm just going to do that. Apply a base first, go in with your color code for two thin layers, cure each layer for 30 seconds, of course, then do your dry brush technique, cure that, add some glitter, add a top coat, cure that again, and then you just go in with your stamping plate image or design, or however you want to call it, and then go over that with a top coat again. Of course, you can use like those stamping gel polishes. I don't own those personally, and I've never tried those either. But of course, if you are using a stamping gel polish, make sure to cure that as well before going in with your top coat. But yeah, oh, this Sakura color, by the way, is so stunning. I really, really love it. So I just applied that popsicle to the pointer finger and the pinky, and then Sakura to the middle. And I think I did exactly the same design for my ring finger as I did on the thumb. So yeah, you can just check that out for yourself now you're watching this video. But like, I just love my pinky colors, and that Sakura color, by the way, is so gorgeous. It is perfect to wear for any occasion. It will look good at any skin tone. Like, don't worry about that. I sometimes get comments on, like, you're very pale, like, every color looks good on you. That's not completely true, because there are, like, some warmer like brownie orange tones that make my skin look really, really like red, with like a reddish undertone, or maybe even a little bit reddish orange yellow, which I personally don't like, but you know, you have to try everything to find out what colors suit your skin tone best. And I think it's like really nice of you guys to say that any color looks good on my nails and my hands, but in person I feel like that's not completely true, but I really appreciate the thought of all of these comments, so thank you. But yeah, I'm just going to stamp on some like loose floral designs to the other nails. As I mentioned, I'm going to do the full-on design down the middle to the ring finger, and I just wanted to add like one loose flower to the other three nails just to tie it in a little bit more. But yeah, I just really love this design. I think it's so cute. Of course, you can recreate this with any other color to your liking. Just switch it up to your personal preference. I would love to do a design like this, and maybe in like green or blue colors or something like that. But unfortunately, I don't really own that many blue gel polishes. I really have to get like back into that to see if there are some cool blue colors that I can get. So yeah, this was actually a really quick and easy design. I just added a top coat once I was done with the stamped images. And after curing that for 30 seconds, I'm going in with a nice cuticle oil. This is actually one by Essence Cosmetics. I really love those. It smells like candy. It is so sweet. And it actually, like, a little bit goes a really long way. So you don't have to apply a ton of the oil. So you can actually work with one bottle for a really long time. But yeah, this was already the entire video. I really hope you liked it. If you have any questions or comments or anything like that, just let me know in the comment section down below. And if you're curious to know how I created the design that is on my left hand, I have already uploaded that one. So take a look at my YouTube channel to see how I made that. So yeah, I really hope you're staying safe and sound and healthy. Let me know how you guys have been doing lately. I've just been working a whole lot, let's just put it to that. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you liked it. Let me know if you will recreate this design or do it in another color or something like that, maybe with regular polishes. But once again, I love you so much, and I would love to see you in one of my next videos.